Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Sip and Sync with Azure. In this episode, we're talking about why coding with agent mode in GitHub Copilot. I am extremely excited about this episode, and I've got Krystal back on the show.
Thank you for having me back. I'm so excited to talk about what agent mode can do today.
Awesome. Okay, so we're going to let's dive right in to see things in action.
All right. So actually today, I'm actually going to show you an application that has a Java application that is able to do microservices with Azure Container Apps. And so this is the original architecture here using Azure Container Apps, where you're able to deploy that to different services. It has a MySQL database and is using our AI endpoints in terms of models. And so I actually just said, hey, as an engineer, I want to convert this application to AKS. Right, so we have a lot of customers, especially Java customers, that are taking applications, modernizing them, and saying, hey, how do we replatform that so that we can put that on the cloud? Yeah. And so I take the Azure architecture, and this is one of our architectures, and I said, I want to actually implement this. And so I'm gonna show you how to take this image and use vision mode within GitHub Copilot, as well as the agent mode to be able to make that successful, and so work with the Copilot.
Awesome, wait, hold on, pause. We're taking an image, we're dropping it into agent mode, and we are going to ask agent mode to replatform, give us a script to replatform our entire application, Java application, into AKS and also have disaster recovery.
Exactly.
That's what we're doing. All right, people, I am very excited. Let's see it.
Awesome. So moving back over to VS Code. So I'm going to copy that image directly into the code IDE in the chat here. So I pasted that into the chat. And then I'm going to just ask it to create that infrastructure for me based on this architecture. And let's see how Copilot takes it.
How it does.
I'm going to ask it based on this architecture from Azure Container Apps and convert it to Azure Kubernetes Services. So Copilot's going to go through that. And the way it works is it basically goes through different processes to try to understand the code and the context that it's trying to do, and also show that it understands the context. So it's kind of learning with you. So you see here, it says the image shows a multi-region setup. So it understands that this is a multi-region AKS, clusters across availability zones and regions. So it already has that powerful knowledge about how to do that. And it's, so it's going to source how to do that with doing that in certain code bases. Yeah. So it's going to know specifically about the files and look through those files. And you see now it's exploring those files and see that I have an AKS file. So it's going to read that Bicep and make sure that it's correct and as it goes through that. And so because of the image had two regions with AKS clusters, it's going to go through that image and actually understand that image and actually uses that to kind of help us build that infrastructure. So then it works here, and you see here it's going to create an implementation plan, and it's going to go through that implementation plan based on the design. So you can take that mock-up framework, you could take a Figma design, and really kind of use that as the image to source the architecture or the plan,
yeah.
Right? So that is really powerful as you're coding and you have design plans or requirements from customers, you can directly pull that in, and you could use the Copilot chat to kind of do that. So as it's doing that, it's going to create directories as well. So you can do that directly through terminal. And I'll show an example here. By the end of all of this, you'll see that the application is going to create some files. It's going to update those files for me, and as well as do what it needs to do to be able to make everything happen.
Yep.
And so that's what really is so powerful about the agent mode, where, you know, before you were doing that single-handedly chat, but with agent mode, it's kind of working more with collaboration to be just not a pair programmer, but more of like your peer, like me and you.
Yeah.
And we're able to kind of work together to kind of brainstorm and ideate through the process. And that is so amazing as what it can do. So this is just kind of one of the cool examples.
Yeah.
You could do this with requirements. Some other things I've seen some great customers already using agent mode for is understanding how to update code as well, migrations, as well as just kind of seeing how to do that to test. You can add accessibility into it. So all the different ways to leverage agent mode to iterate through your application as a whole.
Yeah. And the context is the piece here, right? It's able to see your application on the left, and it's generating constantly the new bicep that you would need to deploy this. And along with that, it's also asking for your input. Like, it's saying, do you want to keep this file, right?
Exactly.
And that's extremely powerful, because this is where you want your getting information from AI, but you want to have full control of what you want to accept or not accept. And it can be detrimental if you end up, you know, doing something, because, you know, it's still AI, it's not a human. And you might end up getting in something that you may not want to keep compliance-wise, security-wise. So very powerful to have some of those controls as well. We'll let it run. But in the meantime, I guess let's talk a little bit about, obviously, we saw the power of really cool just taking a slide of an architecture and being able to generate that, which blows my mind how far we've come with AI, right? But there's definitely implications to having a power like that, right? With high power, or what do we say? With great power comes great responsibility.
Yeah.
So I'll let you talk a little bit about the implications or the burning questions of, yes, agent mode is awesome and vibe coding is amazing, but what do we need to be very careful and aware of?
Yeah, just being careful of, just being aware of how you use that into your production and your productivity. You know, as you implement different agents and how the agent is working, you want to make sure that you still review and check. It's still a paired programmer, so you really want to make sure that you're working with Copilot as it's working, as you could fine tune it and tweak it. So the importance here is to really understand that having the Copilot is there to kind of enhance the experience and productivity, but not replace you. And it's not replacing you, it's just kind of your friend.
Yeah, kind of your buddy, your friend, you're asking questions. You still have to do the compliance piece. You still have to be aware of the security implications and all of that. And again, like, AI is going to be part of improvising on those things as well. But definitely something to be careful of. It does help you get there faster with agent mode, but be careful of all the other things in the background as well, to make sure you're compliant. And with that, thank you so much for walking us through this amazing demo, Krystal. And thank you all for joining us today. I would love, love, love to hear how you're using agent mode. What are the things you've tried? Drop those in the comments below, and we will see you next time.